it's Emily. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about face masks and makeup and how you can prevent your makeup from getting all over the inside of your cloth face masks. So if you're new here, make sure you click that subscribe button down below. That really helps me out. And let's just go ahead and jump on in and get started. So as you have probably figured out, some of the most fashionable face masks are cloth. And you've probably also realized the inside of them are all white. So I have found very few black face masks where it's black on the inside. That does help a little bit as far as like your makeup residue, but it still doesn't help completely. But most of them are white. And what I hate about that is when you wear this up against your face, you are getting makeup all over the inside of your mask. Now, it washes out and things like that, but let's be honest, most people are probably not washing their masks every single day. I know that I have some I keep in my car and my purse and things like that. They don't get washed every single day. So once you wear it, it's got this disgusting look on the inside. Like, I mean, I've been like embarrassed where I'm like folding the mask and like making sure no one sees the inside because it's disgusting when it's covered in makeup. So I've got a couple tips to help take care of that. I've figured out a way to eliminate some of that residue that's going into your cloth face masks. So, first thing, wear a setting spray. Now, I don't use setting spray on a daily basis, or at least I didn't until recently when I figured this out. Most of the time, setting sprays for me have just been for like if you want extended wear of your makeup, but as far as like the day-to-day, going to the office, running around town, running errands, there's no need to wear a setting spray every single day, so I normally don't. But there are a couple setting sprays that I really, really like, and I have found one that really, really helps with this situation. So first, wear a setting spray. Now, I have always liked MAC Fix Plus. It's just the go-to for me. It's just like my ride or die. It's the one I always go with, but I don't keep it around a lot just because I don't wear it all the time. Right now I'm using the MAC Fix Plus Magic Radiance. This one's got a vitamin C serum in it, so it seems the same to me as the regular MAC Fix Plus, but it's supposed to be more hydrating. They do sell one now that's got like shimmer or glitter or something in it. If you wear setting spray with shimmer in it, tell me why in the comments down below, because I cannot imagine spraying glitter all over my face every day. But you would not want to use the glitter ones for this, probably, because it's going to get glitter all over your mask. So you probably want to kind of avoid the shimmer and the glitter with what I'm about to tell you to do. But first thing is wear a setting spray on your face. So this is my go-to for wearing a setting spray on my face. I just like something really basic and something that dries quickly. So this is what I have been using for that. Then, here's the real trick for keeping your cloth masks clean. I have been stashing away this setting spray for a long time. I don't even know if you can still get this one. But it is the Too Faced Peach Mist Mattifying Setting Spray. If you can still get this, I mean, I think you can. I think you can get the rest of the peach line still, but I loved the peach line when it first came out. And I like stashed up. I had like three of these and this is like almost gone. But this one is amazing for putting on the inside of your mask. So I'm going to just kind of show you what it is I do. So I just take my cloth mask and I open it up so that it's like all of the creases of the mask where like the mask comes together, kind of folds outward. Hold it with your hand just like this. And then take your setting spray, and I only do like 2 to 3 pumps of your setting spray. It doesn't need a whole lot. This is an extremely wet setting spray as it is, and it's extremely mattifying, so it almost has like a powder finish to it, which I think is actually really helpful for this. But take your setting spray. That's all it takes. Now, like I said, this one's kind of damp, so you want to let this dry no matter what you're using. Go ahead and let it dry before you put it directly on your face, because even though it's setting spray, if you put that dampness straight onto your face, it's going to rub around. You're going to have more of a mess than what you would have had before. But I have found that this helps a couple things. One, it creates that barrier between the cloth and the makeup on your face. it makes your makeup last longer throughout the day, because if you are wearing a mask, you've probably figured out that by the end of the day, from where this is rubbing around all of this area, you're losing all of the makeup from like your nose down, and it just kind of looks goofy by the end of the day if you are a full face of makeup wearer like I am. So I figured that out, but this setting spray really does the trick. Now, I'm sure if you, I think you can still get this. I'm gonna have to check and see if you can still get this. But if you can still get this one is amazing for a couple reasons. One, like I said, it almost leaves a powder finish. So you have, like, you can feel the layer that it creates on the cloth, which I like. And the powder finish really helps create even more of a barrier than just your liquid setting spray. But this one smells like peaches. And so it smells so good, so that when you go to put your mask on, it's, you have like that fresh peach scent in your mask, which is also really, really nice. So, solve the problem of the makeup on the mask by just using a setting spray on your face, but also on the mask. I think that's the part that people are missing. You can put setting spray on your face all day, but if you have cloth rubbing up against it, it doesn't solve the problem. So just put the setting spray on your mask and you should be good to go. If you guys have any tips or tricks or anything like that for wearing masks with makeup and anything that would help someone else, just leave those suggestions down in the comment section below. I'd love to see them and share them. So if you've got any ideas, let me know. Other than that, that's all I've got for today. So I'll talk to y'all soon. Thanks for watching.